What's up guys, and welcome back to the YouTube video. So in today's video we are going to learn how to remote access and control your Android device in which you have authorization for, and control your Android device within two steps. So it is really simple and easy to set up this ADB and scrcpy and connect it to your own Android device in case need. So you can actually connect it to your Android device from your laptop slash PC, and it is a wireless connection. You can actually, you know, insert some sort of commands as well as different functionalities to the Android device, as well as you can directly screen mirror and directly control your Android device from there itself. So I have already done the video about scrcpy. I have uploaded two videos about that. I'll be providing that in this description. You know where it is. You'll be popping up inside of this screen, probably this left, right. So go ahead and click that, because the first video actually shows how to set up it. I'll be showing that in this video. I'm not really clear on that video, so I thought of creating one more video on how to set up that. And also I have done another video where I actually managed to sort of hack, not a hacking, but you know, prank my brother by actually controlling his Android device by ADB, using the ADB and scrcpy. It was indeed a cool video. It is really worth watching. So without any further ado, let's get started. Nah, not so fast. So I just want to tell you guys that please do like and subscribe to this channel, because it means a lot to me. So if you really value my work, you must subscribe to the channel. So now let's get started.
Disclaimer. This video shows how to use ADB and scrcpy to connect to one's own Android device and screen mirror it. It's an official feature of an Android and used for Android software debugging and testing.
So guys, hope that's a really good intro that I can make. So here now I am on my Kali machine. So let's go ahead and install our ADB and scrcpy, which are the tools for today. And here we are. First of all, open up your terminal and type in sudo apt get install adb, type enter, and type in your sudo password. So it's actually already installed. ADB is already installed. So let's go ahead and install scrcpy to our device. Install scrcpy. So it's generally called scrcpy. Actually, I would like to call it scrcpy for some case. So type in yes to continue, and it is currently getting installed. So there we are, it is currently getting installed, and my internet connection is sort of low, so it's taking a bit more time than expected. So guys, here we are. We have successfully installed scrcpy as well as ADB on our Linux machine. So guys, now let's get started by, you know, unlocking the developer options inside our Android device. So this is POCO C3. So if you can see the screen, but actually it's not currently refreshing the live screen. I don't know. This software is full of shit. So not a problem. So if you can go to the settings of the Android device, you can see an option called about phone. Inside about phone you will see a page like this. Inside in here you can see something called the version number of your Android device. So if you can, as you can see, it's refreshed right over there. So if you can tap on the MIUI version, in my case, for a couple of times, you can see you are 3 steps away from being developer, 2 steps being developer, 1 step away from developer, and now you can see now you are a developer. So now you can go back and back down into the additional settings, and now you can see an additional option there called developer options. So you can go into developer options, and you can see something like this. So guys, there we are. We have successfully enabled the developer options. So now the next step is that scroll down. Why the heck is it doesn't refresh? Scroll down into a section called debugging, and you can see an option called USB debugging. So just bring your code and toggle that on, and it will show a danger signal. So it's not actually danger signal, it's generally a warning signal, if you want to put it like that. So after that, click on I am aware and click on OK, and it will actually work. So as you can see, USB debugging is currently enabled on my device. So now let's go ahead and grab our USB cable and connect our device to our computer. This is only first time, you know, it's not really mandatory after first time connection. So let's go ahead and grab, what the heck is mine? Here we are. So I got my cable. So now let us get started by connecting our USB device to our laptop. So here we are, let's go ahead and plug it in. Here we are, so the Poco C3 is connected to the computer. So so after connection, you may see something called RSA key fingerprint, press on OK and enable that. I have already done that, that's why I'm not getting that confirmation. So let me just go ahead and close the screen mirroring sheet over here, so it's not of no use. So let me just go ahead and close the screen mirroring software over here. So as you can see, I have my terminal right opened over here, if you can zoom in a little bit. And now let me just go ahead and, you know, type in ADB devices, and let's see the list of devices attached to it. As you can see, ADB devices shows a device connected to the computer. So it is actually this Poco C3, you may see something else named as. So after that, just type in ADB TCP IP over the port 5555. It makes the port to be restarted on the Android device. So basically what it does is that it will actually restart the port 5555 on this Android device and make that port to be opened for the arrival of ADB connections to be accepted on the Android device. So guys, now let us go ahead and open up our browser over here. So after opening up your browser, it's not really mandatory to open up your browser. You have to actually find the IP address of this Android device. So I'm trying to use the router's login page to find the IP address of this Android device. So your IP, I am going to type in the gateway IP of my router. So mine can be varying from you guys, so it's not really mandatory to log in into the router's login page. You can actually find out the IP address of the Android device and the device itself. So in case the Android device is not in your hand currently after doing the TCP IP thing, you can actually use the router to connect to your and find the IP address of the Android device. So my name, password, type enter, and hopefully if I can log in. So guys, as you can see right over here inside the network section, you can see something called the client list. So you can see I have currently two devices currently connected to my network. So as you can see, Poco C3 has the IP address of 192.168.225.223. So it's generally the local IP address of this Android device. You cannot actually connect from, you know, across WAN. So coming down into the terminal, you have to type in ADB connect to the IP address, so it will be 192.168.223 over the port 5555. Recall that we have opened the port exclusively for connecting ADB requests. To type enter, and it will actually get connected to your Android device. So it's not really mandatory to plug in your phone after typing the command ADB TCP IP 5555. So let me just go and remove the USB cable from my Android device. So now, as you can see, my Android device is right over here. Now it's time for the moment of magic. Type in scrcpy and type enter, and it will actually generally show up the Android device screen wirelessly over here without any confirmation or any other thing. So it's currently loading up. I don't know why it takes so much time. So as you can see, it is, the Android device is right over there. So it's really faster than the live screen thing. So you can, as you can see, you can actually control your Android device using your mouse right over here. So as you can see, I'm currently loading my Android device using my mouse. So guys, you can actually control your Android device using your mouse right over here. So you can actually type using your keyboard, control using your mouse. So let me just go and show you how the IP address can be seen from the device itself. You don't actually have to log in into your router's login page. Generally, you have to be connected to a Wi-Fi network for this to work, because you need the local IP address of this Android device. So go inside the additional settings. I mean, not in the additional settings. Just go and search for, as you can see right over there. I don't have to be showing your phone again and again. So as you can see, if you type in IP addresses, click on IP address, you can see the IP address right over there. You can see the IP address is right over there. 192.168.225.23. So you can use that along with the port number to actually connect to your Android device. So that's it. We have connected to our Android device. Let me just turn the screen off. So now it's time to actually tell you guys about my other video. So this is just the tip of the iceberg. So if you want to watch that video, if you're really interested in this topic, ADB has really vast things that you can actually do using ADB. So now is a great moment to tell you guys about my other two videos. So if you're really interested and like this video, you may also like that two videos, because there I actually managed to show what all things that you can do using ADB, the tricks, the pranks, the things that you can do using ADB. Go out and watch this video. I'll be providing here in the annotated sidebar, whatever that is. So I am going to place two videos there. If you're really interested into this topic, it will be really, really awesome to watch that too. So thank you guys for watching this video. Please make sure that you like and subscribe to my channel. And also watch that other two videos that I have already provided here or here, whatever that is. So go ahead and watch that video. It will be really awesome. So there I actually showed how to control and remote access an Android device like as if a ghost was inside the Android device. So it will be a really awesome video. So if you have any questions or comments regarding this topic, just put it on the comments below. I'll be definitely checking that. So thank you for watching and have a nice time. We'll be right back.